Today's concept is how to create a thread using a thread class. Mainly, if you want to create a thread in Java, there are two approaches are there: by extending thread class or implementing runnable interface. Today's concept is by extending thread class, how we can create a thread. Just we will go, and if you see this screen here, just a main method is there. I am writing some small code only. Here I am printing the main method. Now if I run this code, if I execute this code, what it will print? So if I execute this code, it is printing main. It's a simple Java program. I am not created any threads. But if you see here, this line is executed by one thread. So this line is executed by a thread, but the thread is not created by me. The thread is created by the JVM. It's already created by the JVM. What is that thread name? The thread name in Java, each and every thread has by default some name will be there. If you want, we can give our own customization name to the our threads. Like that, the JVM created one thread and the thread is executing this main method. So by default, Java program contains single thread. One thread will be there, one main thread will be there. This thread will execute your entire Java program. If you want more efficient, from that thread you can create any number of threads. So by default, what are the threads will be available in Java? One thread, main thread. If you want to print that name, how can we print? Suppose this line is executed, the line number 6 is executed by the main thread. So how to get the object of a main thread? Simply, thread t is equal to, I want the currently executing thread, means main thread. Who created the thread? JVM already created. So simply I will write thread dot current thread. So thread dot current thread, this method is a static method, that's why I am calling directly with respect to the class. Now this method will return the currently executing thread, means this line is executed by the which thread. The thread object will comes under stores into the t. Now if I want to get the name of t dot, simply get name. Now if I run this code, I am getting main. So that thread name is main. What is the thread name? Main. Who created this thread? JVM is already created the thread. So I am not creating this thread. Suppose if I want to create the thread, if I want to create a thread, how can I create the thread? Simply, if I want to create the thread, simply what I will do, I will extend my class by using thread class. Thread class is belongs to the java.lang package. I will extend. Now whatever the features, whatever the variables and methods available in thread class automatically inherited to the my thread demo class. Now I will create thread demo t1 is equal to new thread demo. I simply created a, so if you want to create a thread, first, what is the first rule? You need to extend your class thread. You need to extend thread class. And second, you just create your object. Before that, you just override the method, run method. So run method is available in thread class. Already it's an available, but there is a empty logic. There is no logic is available in run method by default in thread class. So you just write any logic. Suppose for example, I am writing Yes, I am writing a for loop. It will iterate 10 times. And I am printing I am in run method. Now after completing, what I will print? If you see here some important law. So end of run method. Now, so what is the, if you want to create a thread, the first rule is you need to extend a thread class. Second rule is you need to override the run method, and third one is write some business logic in run method, and fourth one is create the object of your customization class, and fifth one is t1 dot call start method. Now here end of main method. Now it is the complete, now program is completed. Just if you want to create a thread, remember these points. What is the first point? You need to extend thread class, that is the first point. And second point, you need to override run method, that is the second rule. And third rule is you need to write some business logic in run method. And fourth point is you need to create the object of your whatever the class is extending thread, maybe this class or some other class. And fifth rule is call this thing. Now if I execute this thing, yeah, if you see the first statement is end of main, but in middle I am in run, it prints 10 times because the loop is iterating for 10 times, and end of run. It is a not guarantee, you don't fix end of main will always comes under first. It is a not a mandatory, because sometimes it will comes under middle also. If you see, if you observe, end of main will come sometimes in middle of the I am in run. Yeah, if you try, sometimes it will definitely come. Yeah. In previous attempt, if you see, end of main comes at 1 minute. Yeah, run few times like this. Because what is happening here, two threads. By default, main thread is created by the JVM, and one more thread created by me, that thread. So, one thread is executing run method, and one thread is executing main method at a time. So, we can't say every time main method will execute first, next our created thread will execute next. We can't say like that. It is based on the your JVM and operating system. Yeah, I hope it's not coming, but most, yeah, if you see in this situation, first executed, whatever the thread I am creating, this thread will be, means my thread executed first, and second main thread will be executed. Sometimes what is happening, this thread will execute in middle of this my thread. Sometimes there is a chance. So we can't expect like that. Maybe we will get, if you write any delay, any sleep functions, you will observe that difference clearly. So what is happening here, the first public, this method will be executed by the JVM. Here this line is executed by the main thread, and this line is also executed by the main thread. Whenever this line is executed, internally one more thread is created, and that thread is responsible for executing of this run method. So t1 dot start, this line is executed by the main thread only, and this code is executed by the our created thread. So this is the line executed by the main thread. So if you see here, this line, whenever the main thread is executing this line, main thread is going to executing this line is also executed by which thread? Main thread only. T1 dot start is executing by main thread only. Now after this method is executing, one more thread is creating, because one thread main. Now what is this doing? It is creating one more thread, and main thread is remaining sim like this only. This is main and my thread. By default, the name of my thread is thread 0. So now this thread is executing this run block. So this is the thread, T1 thread. This T1 thread is executing this code. This block of code is executing by T1 thread, and this coding is executed by the main thread. So that is the first one. So if you want to create a thread, you need to extend, first rule is you need to extend a thread class, you need to override a run method, and you need to write the business logic through the run method and create the object of which class you extended. In this situation, I thread demo, I extended thread class, so I created object and I called start. Once if you call start method, what is the internal logic of start method, I will explain later. So this is the one way, and one more way is also there. So what is that way? By extending thread class only. So in previous, what is the first point? Extend a thread class. Yeah, here also extend a thread class. So first point, here also extend a thread class. This is the second way, and override run method, that is the second point. And third point is write a business logic in run method. Fourth point is create a object of this class, whatever the class is extending thread, create the object. Here up to here, whatever the previous code is there, same code. But now don't call t1 dot start. In previous code, if you see, I directly called t1 dot start after creating object. Now what I am doing is I am creating a thread object. I am creating a one more object. In previous line, I created a my class object. Now I created a thread object. For this thread object, I am passing a thread instance t1. T1 I am passing. So what is happening? Thread dot start. Thread dot start means this thread internally calls this T1 object based run method only, means this code will internally execute. There are two ways. You can directly write T1 dot start. This is the one way. Otherwise, if you are not interested to call T start method corresponding to T1, you just pass the T1 object to thread class, and thread class constructor and thread class object you just call thread dot start like this. The second way, there are two ways are there. So same, both are the same ways, but difference is in this previous you are directly calling start method based on your custom object, but in this approach you are calling the start method on the predefined class thread class by passing the custom object to this thread. This is the second approach. Now what I have a doubt, suppose I am not overriding run method. If I am not overriding run method, what will happens? I am creating a thread. So simply I am extending a thread class. So my class will inherit the thread behavior. Now my class is not a normal class, my class is a thread class, because whatever the methods, whatever the variables present in the thread, all are inherited to this class. Now I created object to my class and I called start. Start method is present in thread demo T1. What is the T1 object type? Thread demo. Start method is present in thread demo? No, not present. So it will go to the thread class. So it will not there in thread demo, but inherited from thread. So the start method is inherited from the parent class thread. Now the start method is there or not there? Yeah, there, but you are unable to see. Why? The start method is inherited from the parent class. Now this start method is execute. What this start method will do? It will create a thread, and the thread will call the run method of this object. So t1.run it will call internally. What it will call? t1.run. Who will call? The newly created thread will call. This line is executed by my main thread only, not newly created thread. So this line is executed by my main thread. After this line, the start method, whatever the logic writing in start method, one thread will be created, and the thread will be called the run method. But run method is present in t1 object, means thread demo, there is no run method. So you are not overriding the run method. What will happen? The run method, whatever the run method present in the thread class, that run method will be executed. So thread is created or not in this case? Yeah, created. Executed or not? Executed. But what is the logic? There is no logic, because in thread class run method is implemented like this. There is empty logic, empty body, so nothing will be executed. So if you see same situation here, I am not going to override the run method. So I am not going to override the run method. Now I am running it is running end of main. The thread is created, and thread is also going to the dead states automatically. Why? I am not going to override the run method. Then the super class, thread class run method is executing. What is the logic of thread class run method? There is no logic. It's an empty body, so it's not executing anything. Now same thing. Now my doubt is that possible to override the start method in our class? Yes, it is possible to override the start method also, but it is not recommended, because what is the logic in start method? If you go to the Java documentation, this is the given Java API given this document API given the logic internal implementation of start method. If you observe here some points, so what is here? This is the Java API given start method implementation. So if you call t1.start, so which thread will execute this line? Main thread, not newly created thread. This line is executed by the main thread. Now the main thread is entered into the start method. This start method is belongs into the thread class. Now what is the first line if condition? This line is executed by the main thread only, not newly created thread. Just remember this point. So many of people will confuse this one only. So this line is executed by the main thread only. So after executing total start method, what it is calling? It is calling start zero method. So start method internally calls start zero method. Start zero method is also belongs to the thread class. This start zero method is not a Java method. This start zero method is in a OS dependent method. Means OS dependent method means it is not a Java method based on your OS. Suppose if you are Windows, this method is a C language maybe, or some other operating system, this method implementation may be in Pascal, COBOL, some C++. We can't say which language. So this is a native method. So start method is executing by the start method is, just remember one thing, the start method is executing by the main thread only executing start method. After executing start method, main thread is also calling the start method. We are calling start zero method. So once if you call start zero method, the main thread work is completed, then this main thread is returned to the your application. Once start method is completed, the main thread will return to the your application, and once start zero method is invoked, then there is no logic. So start main thread is returned to the your application. But JVM, once anyone can called the start zero method, then what happens? JVM will create a thread. JVM will create a thread and calls the run method of that thread. simply. Now you can ask, then this time what I will do, instead of calling start method, I will directly call start zero method from your application. It is not possible, because your start zero method is in a private method. You can't call that method, or you can't see that method implementation. That too, it is a native method. Who native methods will called by whom? JVM only, because it is a C language method, you can't call directly. So after completion of start method, the thread is returned to the your Java main application. Now, so can we override a start method? Yes, you can override. But if you override a start method, this behavior will not come by default. So you can't create a thread. So if you not override a run method, you can't write any thread will be created, but there is no logic to execute for the thread. So thread will be created and going to the dead state immediately. If you override start method, what will happen? Your thread behavior will be collapsed, going to collapse. That is the main disadvantage. So in by default, there are JVM is creating a main thread. So main thread created by JVM, how it is creating? It is also creating by like calling start method. No, JVM creates a main thread without calling a start method. It by directly it is calling a native method start zero and creating a thread and giving and calling the main and assigning the main function directly. So that's why the first point, the main thread will execute from this one only. So that is the difference between the thread created by the JVM and thread created by us. Our thread directly goes to the start method. From start method, it will go to the native functions. But JVM created thread automatically directly goes to the native functions and create the thread and execute the main function. That is the main difference between our created thread and JVM created thread. And that is the internal logic of start method and start zero method. So, and once I have one more doubt, if I call t1 dot start two times, what will happen? If I have a chance to call t1 dot start means what will happen? Your run method will be executed. But if I call two times t1 dot start, what will happen? Means t1 dot start means one new thread will be created, and that new thread will be execute the run method. Now again, if you call t1 dot start, it is not possible to create a new thread, and this is not possible to create a new thread. So what it will do, it will throw an exception, illegal state exception. So it's a not recommended to call. If you see here in the console, illegal thread state exception means the thread state is illegal. Why illegal? Already t1 dot start means what happens internally? One thread is created and it is executing run method, and thread is dead. Now you are again calling t1 dot start. So what will happen? Again it is trying to create a thread, but already thread is created. Now what it is throwing? Illegal thread state exception. So once thread is created and thread is dead, you can't use that thread. So you can't call t1 dot start second time. If you call more than one times, it will throw an exception. So that is the today's class about thread, how to create a thread using a thread class. Thank you.